Hey Aquarius, welcome back to Sylvivin with Carrie, back again with another tarot card reading here for you. So this tarot card reading, Aquarius, is going to be all about self-love, okay? So a self-love tarot reading just for you, okay? We're going to dive deep into your energy and what it is that you can do for self-care, for body, mind, and spirit. Okay, Aquarius, so if that's something that you're interested in, I'm going to go ahead and put my camera down and pre-shuffle all my cards. So I'll be laying out the cards before I turn the camera on, and then I will get into your reading. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in just a minute. Hey, Aquarius. Okay, so here is your tarot card reading for whenever you come across this video, okay? Because this is a self-care reading, Aquarius. So we're going to tune into your energy to see. I already did. I mean, obviously, I laid out all the cards for you. So Aquarius, we're going to start off with these two cards here, which are going to tell me the heart of the matter and what's going on with you, basically, okay? So we're going to tune in. Now, the Warrior. Okay, Aquarius, so this is telling me a lot about you in the current moment. And you get the Mirror. So what I'm seeing is that some of you may be standing protective, or you're like this warrior, okay? Now, whether you are the good warrior or the bad warrior, or I should say evil warrior, okay, that's completely going to be answered by you and you yourself only. Aquarius, what I see here is that you do need to do some reflection within yourself to see if you have been acting out as, you know, the evil or the good warrior here, okay? Because with the Mirror here, I do feel like there is a need for reflection to be done in order to move to the next forward and bring in this transformation, because the back of the deck energy for your tarot cards was death. Okay, so to me, that just means that you're going through a transformation and you may be hanging on to some things that no longer serve you. So just go ahead and do some reflecting on that, okay? If you feel like that resonates with you. Now, as a general reading, though, I do want to say that it may not resonate with everybody, okay? But let's keep moving forward, because I do have tons of cards here, and something here might resonate with you if you feel like these two don't resonate with you, okay? Now, I do want to point out that the back of the deck energy for the spirit animal is the Panther, which is also a card of overprotectiveness, or you're standing protected or guarded in some type of way, because the Panther also guards the jungle, correct? With the Warrior card here, I also see that you may be standing guarded in some type of way, okay? This may be because it's your way of protecting your energy or protecting yourself. While that's okay, just know that there's other ways you can protect your energy as well, such as by using crystals. So let's go ahead and tune into the tarot. So first we get the Four of Wands, okay, which is beautiful energy. I feel like your home life is very stable, very secure. Partnerships are going, or might be going, very well at the moment. However, with another number four here, okay, we get number 44. Look into meaning for a number, angel 44. You get the Four of Cups. So some of you may be feeling bored at the moment, and I'm going to go ahead and bring this into balance for you guys as well. So I'm going to be giving you what each card means for self-care, okay, for mind, body, and spirit. And then last, you get the Justice card. Okay. So what I'm seeing, Aquarius, for this tarot reading with the Four of Wands, I see that some of you need to celebrate, okay? Some of you need to just take some time out to just have some fun, okay? If having fun is not an option for you at the moment, Aquarius, what I'm seeing is that your mind is telling you to maybe do something out of the ordinary or something different, like listening to podcasts might help you out at the moment. So ask your friends for podcast suggestions and listen to them while you do chores around your house or whatever. Okay, also what I'm seeing with body, your body is asking for yoga. Okay, stretching, yoga, and connecting with your spirit in that way. Okay, doing yoga is really going to help you, Aquarius. Also with the Four of Wands, make a gratitude list of what you're most appreciative for, okay? Everything around you, make that list and be thankful for everything you have. With the Four of Cups, that's where I see the boredom kicking in. I feel like some of you guys do need to just rearrange
things around your home to make things feel a little bit different. And so you stepping into a different, basically rearranged home, that's really going to help uplift your spirit as well. But this is also calling you to do some type of activity such as cardio, yoga, or something of that nature, okay? Also connect with carnelian stone. Have you guys seen carnelian? Sometimes I have it in my readings. It's a red stone. It's very beautiful. That helps ground you and it helps motivate you. So if you're feeling bored at the moment, that's what's going to help you like get things done and, you know, feel a little bit more optimistic about what's about the energies around you. Okay, Aquarius. So overall, I do love the energy around you. I just feel like there's just a need for a little bit of switching things around in order to help you feel more balanced as well. Okay, now the Justice card here is going to be one that's very highlighted in your reading, okay? Because what I'm seeing here is that you do need to take some time out to recharge, because I feel like some of you, your energy field is just, you're feeling like you're uninspired or bored, like I said, but this is also bringing and clarifying this up for me. It's like confirming that, you know, there is something that's just kind of either holding you back or you feel like it's just not your usual self. Okay, Aquarius. And this is nothing bad, but you know, this, you feeling uninspired or you struggling in this certain type of way, what I'm seeing is that some of you may just need to, I'm getting yoga and Pilates again, part of your morning routine, okay? So change your morning routine up in some type of way. Even if you just go for a walk around the block, that's really going to help you, Aquarius. Okay, also your spirit is asking that you align your energy by honoring spirit. Make sure you're living honestly, okay, and holding yourself accountable for any missteps you take. We all create mistakes. We all are at fault for our own mistakes as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and tune into your spirit animal. You get the beaver, which is also a family card. Okay, your family is very stable. You may be the rock or the center of your family, where your family goes and visits you. Maybe you're a mom, or you know, you're just that one that holds the family down and keeps harmony in place. Okay, with the frog card here, okay, I feel like there is some things you need to release. Okay, this may have to do with your past, and this may have to come up to you when you do some reflection. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, Aquarius, because this is just my reading for you, and I want to be clear and honest. When I was meditating on your reading, I did keep seeing a lot of battles, or you fighting a battle, or you going through something, a lot of like inner turmoil is what I'm hearing as well for some of you. And this may just be cleared really easily if you do like, what, you know, maybe do yoga or groundwork or something like that, but also by doing reflections, okay? Really reflecting back the way you're acting with people and reflect it back to yourself, okay? With the frog energy here, what I'm seeing is that you're going through a period of time where your energy field needs more cleansing than usual, okay? Because you're going through healing, okay? And you are going to find this healing within you, if that's something that you're curious and wondering about, because there's a transformation happening within you, okay? So this card serves as a reminder that water helps us cleanse, forgive, and release. Okay, so you're being asked to release something and really maybe go to a body of water or something, maybe take a bath, or when you're taking a shower, really meditate in the shower, okay? So we get baby steps, action, follow your intuition before it makes sense. There's things that are coming to your awareness is what I'm hearing, okay? These are baby steps guiding you in order to come to where you are supposed to be, okay? Also, let's go ahead and tune into, wow, the void. Stop, embrace winter, great cosmic moon. So this is telling me, you guys, I feel like you guys have gone through a spiritual awakening, or most of you here. But with the void, I feel like you guys are stuck in the dark night of the soul is what I'm hearing. So you guys may be feeling kind of like uninspired, kind of like, oh, like you know a lot about life, but yet there's more, you know, there's more, and you want to get out of this kind of rut you're in. And it's because you're here. There's transformation coming though, because you do get the back of the deck energy. Nine of Swords, yeah. So there's a, maybe some of you can't sleep at night is what I'm hearing as well. So for your self-care, you get watch a movie, okay, to help balance out your energy, cuddle with your cat, have some tea or coffee, do something different, okay? Wow, some of you, you're being asked for a health checkup. Also, that's what I saw with the Justice card here, okay? When I was reading into the Justice card for self-care, what I saw was that some of you may need to, you know, if you feel like you need help or you feel like mentally you're not feeling okay, Aquarius, go ahead and make the health checkup for yourself, okay? There's nothing wrong with visiting a psychologist or a doctor just to make sure everything is okay. Okay, like if you're feeling depressed, because the void is also like a dark place, you know? Because you may be going through this period of healing within yourself. So we also get hydrate. Some of you, this is again water, being around water and near water. Maybe you need more water in your life to help feel more energized, or to help bring you into balance, okay? Especially around full moons, Aquarius, what I've noticed is that if I don't have enough water, which I'm super thirsty already, so that's like an indicator that maybe you guys are thirsty. And honestly, before, I'm clairsentient, you guys. So before I started doing your reading, I got really, really thirsty, and I had been drinking water. So I don't know, maybe that's an indicator. And you guys got also got the hydrate card. So Aquarius, let's go ahead and tune into your mermaids. So you get change, know when to move into a new shell, especially if yours no longer fits. So what needs to be changed here, Aquarius? You're getting to change your furniture, change your, you know, I'm not saying buy new stuff, unless you want to, of course, but what I'm saying is that there's a need for change here. Only you have the answer to this, okay? Protection, again, you get protection here and here and here, okay? So protection keeps the aquamarine close. Mermaids tears have been known to create these precious gems. Some of you are being overprotected, or you need to be a little bit more protective of your energy around this time, okay? Cleanse your energy. All right. Very beautiful though overall, Aquarius. I hope you like this reading. It's very different than most of my readings. We're gonna go ahead and pull out your divination dice and your sparks of balance. So here you get the crown, your crown chakra, connect to spirit, connect to God, okay? You also get the rainbow. So you are gonna find this rainbow, okay? Just keep your head up is what I'm hearing. Also the castle, your home, okay? Again, clear your home, change the energy around it. You are this magician, okay? You're going to get through everything you do as always, okay? And then you get the little tornado in the reverse or upright, however you feel resonates with you. I feel like this is an inner battle you're fighting, okay? Everything's gonna turn out okay. Apparently I put these in the order. Oh, look, a bicycle. Some of you guys can like go bicycle riding, okay? Ride your bicycle, go cycling, take a cycling class maybe. Let's go ahead and pull out your sparks of, oh shoot, your sparks of balance and kindness here. So let's see what we have. It says, make promises and keep them. Do something unpredictable. You're really being asked to do something different here with do something unpredictable. Practice forgiveness, work to heal an old misunderstanding or grudge. So this is one way, you guys. I do feel that's a big topic I felt for your energy. Like there's something you're holding on to that you really need to let go, okay? Also, you get do something you find soothing. So maybe for you, maybe this is watching a movie. Maybe there's a point in your life where you used to like watching movies, maybe as a kid or when you were younger, and you're just being called to, you know, do something that you really haven't done in a while, Okay, that's gonna help you. Okay, Aquarius, that is all I have for you. Thank you so much for tuning into your self-care tarot reading. Tune into your love tarot reading next week if you would like. And give me a thumbs up. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.